Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make your own neon sign. This is a revised version of one I did quite a while ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. I provided this brick wall for you to download. Its link is located in the video description or project files. The size is 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. To fit the image onto your screen, press Ctrl-0 on a PC or Command-0 on a Mac. Let's make the brick wall dark. Click on the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Levels. We need to see more of the Levels properties, so hover your cursor just below the window until you see a vertical double arrow. Then drag it down. Now we can see the output levels. In the right box, type in 60. If you feel the brick wall is too dark, you can always increase the number later. Open your Type tool and choose a font. I'm using Freestyle Script. If you'd like to use it, I provided that link as well. I'm choosing a size of 191 points, sharp, and left alignment. Click on the color box and pick white. Then click OK. Type out your text. To move a line to the right, click to the left of the first character of the line and press and hold Alt or Option plus the right arrow key on your keyboard. To increase or decrease the space or kerning between two characters, click between them using the same characters of Alt or Option plus the left or right arrow keys. Continue to kern your characters until all of your text looks good. Go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. Click on your Move tool. To angle your text, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it counterclockwise. Click inside to reposition it. Then press Enter or Return. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the text to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select and Save Selection. We'll name it Text and click OK. Since neon tubes are relatively thin, we'll delete the center portion of our text, making it look more like thin tubes. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. I'll contract it by 4 pixels. Depending on the size of your text, play with the amount of contraction to see what looks good to you. Then click OK. Press Delete to get rid of the areas inside the selection. Press Ctrl or Command D to delete the selection. We're ready to add color and glows to our text. Double-click on its thumbnail to open the Layer Style window. Click Color Overlay. Click on the color box and pick a color. Pick a medium shade of a color you like. I'll choose 6E-AAFB for mine. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Pick a slightly darker or richer shade of the same color as you picked just before. For mine, I'll type in 0B5BFF. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 75%, and the size is 10 pixels. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is multiply, the opacity is 100%, the distance is 5 pixels, and the size is 7 pixels. Make a copy of the text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click on Outer Glow and change its blend mode to Color Dodge and its opacity to 100%. Click on the color box and pick a medium shade of your color. I'm typing in 5B8FF9. Make the size approximately 100 pixels and uncheck Drop Shadow. Then click OK. Next, we'll add a thin inner glow to make it look more like neon tubes. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Let's name it Tube Highlight. Control-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of your text to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. I'll contract it by 1 pixel. Feel free to experiment with this amount. We'll fill it with white, and since white is the background color, press Control or Command plus Delete. Then delete the selection. To blend the inner glow into your neon color, change the blend mode to overlay. We're ready to make the neon glow on the brick wall. Make the adjustment layer active. We'll place the brick glow above this layer. Make a new layer, and we'll name it Brick Glow. Open your Channels panel, and Control-click or Command-click on the text channel that you saved earlier to make a selection of its shape. Open back up your Layers panel, and go to Select and Refine Edge. Feather it 50 pixels, and shift the edge 70%. Then click OK. Fill the selection with white and delete the selection. Change the blend mode to overlay. Double-click on the thumbnail of the brick glow to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. Pick a rich shade of your color. I'm picking 0042FF. Change the blend mode to color and reduce the opacity to 70%. We'll add one more glow to the brick wall to make our sign really pop. Make a new layer and name it Brick Glow 2. Open your Channels panel and, as before, Control-click or Command-click on the text channel and open back up your Layers panel. Go to Select and Refine Edge. Feather it 50 pixels, and this time shift the edge 40%. Fill it with white and delete the selection. Change the blend mode to overlay. Go to the effects of the original brick glow and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it to Brick Glow 2. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.